Hey, what's up, my people? As usual, Kelvin Mashari is my name. And first of all, I just want to begin by saying that I'm born again and I love the Lord. It's been an amazing week for me, and I sure hope it's been an amazing week for you as well. The reason why we do this is because we love God and we need to spread the gospel to the ends of the earth. As Psalms 61, the scripture says that, to the ends of the earth. And now I'd like us to bring to our attention this week concerning the theme of hide your face. One thing you have to understand is that God will never hide his face from you, but rather he will hide his face from your sin. We have looked in the series of brokenness, and we still are in the series of brokenness, where David prayed a very powerful prayer. And for me personally, it is the season where Psalms 51 and Psalms 91 come into context. Now, Psalms 51 verse 8 this week for us concerning hide your face, it is that David, in his prayer, he said, make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones you have broken may rejoice. And in verse 9, he continued to say that hide your face from my sin and blot out all my iniquities. What a revelation this man had concerning the face of God, that he would hide his face from David's sin. One thing about sin, let me tell you, point number one, it is that sin brings a disconnection between you and God. Sin is not just anything that is against God, but sin brings a disconnection between you and God. And David knew exactly that he had a disconnection from God. This week, I pray that you will not have any disconnection in Jesus' name. I pray that this moment, as you watch this video, it is that your face will be on the book, which is called the Bible. The Bible says this, that he will not leave us, neither forsake us. And in this season, I believe with all my heart in Jesus' name, it is that God will not hide his face from you. Have the confidence in him that his face is ever watching. Another scripture that I'm reminded in the Chronicles, it is that he says, my eye is upon the righteous. Do you believe that you're the righteousness of God? Point number two is this, is that as long as God will not hide his face from you, point number two is this, his eye is upon you. David knew that the eye of God is watching me, even in this prayer. How I pray that God, you will hide your face. By the fact that God hid his face from sin, it meant that God had mercy on David. And in this season where we are still believing God for a breakthrough from this virus, it is my request to you that you will focus on God. And point number three, it is that God is an amazing God. He's an amazing God, to the point that David said, the bones that you have broken in verse 8, the bones that you have broken will rejoice. David, deep inside his heart, he knew that he had forsaken the Lord. It is not that the Lord forsook him, but David was the one who forsook the Lord. At times, I do believe that when we mess up, we don't feel as if we want to pray. We don't feel as if we want to fellowship. We don't feel as if we want to be in the midst of believers. Trust you me this day and this week that God is still on your side. And I'm here to encourage you. Personally, I have found myself there whereby as if I am alone, but God is with me. He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will not fear any evil. So even at this time, God will not hide his face from you. And I repeat it again with all confidence. God will not hide his face from you, but rather he will hide his face from your sin. Allow me to pray with you as I conclude. Father, in Jesus' name, I just want to thank you for your word. I just want to thank you for this period where we do understand that, God, you will not hide your face from us. Lord, you dealt with our sin, our mistakes, our misery at the cross. And we do know that your face is upon us. Your eye is upon us. And right now, in Jesus' name, I just pray that, Lord, we will focus on your face.
We give you all the glory, we give you all the honor, because God, we do understand that you're the Lion of the tribe of Judah, and in you will we put our trust. This I pray in Jesus' name. Until next week, my people, God bless you. Shalom.